I held it all together as well as I could over that year. It was just kind of, it was rough. I'd always been able to leap over tall buildings in a single bound. I was a superhero because I just always kept pushing through no matter what. But all of those years had just worn on me. And when that year of family tragedies happened, our business started to suffer from all of that. And we ended up having to close our business in the end. That led to us giving up most of our belongings and our home and starting over completely. And I fell to absolute pieces when our life fell to pieces that time around. I couldn't get myself back together no matter how hard I tried. I finally broke after so many years of trying to hold everybody together and hold everything together. I just broke. I broke and I broke and I broke. And I was so incredibly exhausted physically, but mostly it was mentally and emotionally. My heart was shattered. It was just, I was so brokenhearted. My dreams were shattered. I wanted to give up, and it honestly took everything in me to not give in to just wanting to be completely done with life. I couldn't talk to people, I couldn't think, I couldn't write, I couldn't dream, I couldn't leave my house. I just fell to pieces and I completely lost hope for a while. And I was so ashamed that I couldn't pull myself back together like I always had. I had amazing soul working tools. I just couldn't pull myself together. So soul work did come to the rescue though. And that whole ordeal might be one of the very best things that ever happened to me because it set me on a different course for my life. One that was that is sustainable and even joyful. That's when we decided to become Freebird Nomads. And then the pandemic came. And I am getting through that experience and this experience and growing through this experience by doing soul work. So here's the deal, my friends. We can't learn to be resilient without having to travel through the very things that teach us what we're capable of. Sometimes there's just not any other way. There's no way that we can ever know what we're able to do until we're faced with absolutely having to do it. No other choice. And deciding to stay awake for it. Looking at it and walking through it and walking toward it rather than numbing and running away from it. That's what soul work helps us do. Helps us look at what's happening and decide what our next move will be, what our next thought will be, and remembering that we're powerful enough to do that. I never would have thought I was as strong and resilient as I have grown to be. And I also never would have known how very fragile and wobbly and weak that I am in certain places. I never could have known any of that about myself until I was pushed to the limit of the limit of the limit of the limits of what I'm capable of, just like you. We get to go through things that are painful and difficult and tedious and unfair and unjust and complicated and terrifying. We get to do this. And sometimes there's no other way to become more than we ever dreamed that we could be. There's no other way for us to get to where we most want to be as human beings. And we get to learn joy. Oh, how we learn joy. And we learn appreciation and we learn awe. And all the little things in life become the big things. They become the miracles because we start to actually notice them after they hang in the balance and we almost lose them. We learn to really live rather than just sleepwalk through life on autopilot, doing the same thing day after day, often just kind of numbing out, doing whatever we can to numb out our feelings, and we miss it. We miss life. We wouldn't even know that a perfectly ripened raspberry tasted sweet and magical if we never tasted bitter things or unsweet things or even really disgusting things or burnt things. We wouldn't know how good warm, dry clothes feel if we've never been wet and cold. We wouldn't know how beautiful and good an embrace feels and deep eye-to-eye contact with people that we love if we didn't have the opportunity to feel alone and isolated. And hard times don't last forever. Easy times don't last forever either. All of the times we get to experience teach us though. And that is what does last forever. We get to take our becoming with us. We get to take our experience, our wisdom, and our change of heart with us. That's what is real. That's what is lasting. So if you're going through a hard time right now, please take heart. You're growing through what you're going through. You're smack dab in the middle of tremendous opportunities to not only learn about yourself, but to become who you want to become next. You are becoming more than you ever, ever could have dreamed of becoming. So stick with it. Good days are ahead. They're always ahead. And more hard days are ahead too, but very good days are ahead, and all of it is worth it. It's what we're here for. Soul work has saved me every time, and I want that for you. You're phenomenal. You're a miracle. You're so easy to love. So let's be thankful for the hard times we've made it through. You made it through yesterday. You're making it through today, and you really will make it through tomorrow, and you'll be more than you ever were. So come do some soul work with me. I don't have the answers, but I do have the questions to help you find the answers. I love you.